Welcome everyone, Age of Noob here, covering the newly released Age of Empires 4 gameplay from the fan preview. In this series, we'll be looking at each age's gameplay individually. The third of the ages, the Castle Age. For the Castle Age, we witness the clash of the Delhi Sultanate against the English. This is where we see Age of Empires 4 significantly varying compared to Age of Empires 2. Walls and towers now are much taller, bigger, and more realistic that surrounds the town within. More importantly, archers can finally man the walls and shoot from the high ground. They must have a high ground advantage versus the enemy units, so sieging a town should be a much larger undertaking compared to Age of Empires 2. In my opinion, this is great because it adds a ton of realism and heft to sieges compared to earlier games in the franchise. We can also see the usage of rams and siege towers to soak up the arrows. More importantly, it seems like the siege tower will no longer be a meme unit, as enemy soldiers will be able to climb on the walls and actually fight up against the defenders if they're able to climb up. Once again, a great sieging mechanic that we have not seen before. There are two things to note here though. There is some stuttering in the original footage, so I'm pretty sure they'll work on the performance before and after they release the game and improve it. I have a feeling that we'll need some beefy computers to handle large sieges, especially in 4K resolution. Another quick call out here is that the unit attack animations against buildings are too far from the buildings themselves, so this is something that I hope they will fix before the release. Also, an interesting choice from the developers was to still allow melee units to destroy large stone buildings. Given the scale change in the game, I suspected that only hefty siege weapons would be able to break down walls and castles, but the developers still kept the same mechanic of melee units being effective against buildings as a returning mechanic. This isn't a good or a bad thing per se, just pointing out the design choice that they made in Age of Empires 4. That said, the crumbling destruction animations are definitely lacking. Once again, given that this is a new game with a new engine, I'm sure they'll be able to add more detailed destruction animations, as, in my opinion, the crumbling animations are currently lacking for a modern game. Also, if you'd like to always be up to speed with Age of Empires 4 content and news, please consider subscribing and giving the thumbs up, it really helps out the channel. Another interesting detail is that it seems that most units, be it mounted or not, seem to have a running charge mechanic for a powerful attack. We can see some examples here with the lancers as well as the pikemen. We also see some monks healing the elephants here, so it is confirmed that monks will return to the franchise as the healers of the game. Another detail that I appreciate are the crossbow reload animations. The developers seem to have put some thought behind every unit now, as in Age of Empires 2, all arrows were shot directly and they all looked the same, despite the inherent differences in the weapons and arrows that were used. So all in all, this is a great change. In summary, it seems like we'll be able to have high pressure sieging in Castle Age as well if you have a large enough army to push through the gates and climb the walls. Well, this wraps up the first look of Castle Age in Age of Empires 4. Be sure to check out the Dark, Feudal, and Imperial Age first looks on our channel as well. This is Age of Noob, hope you all enjoy the summary, and see you all in the next one.